What up, my YouTube fam? It's your friend Albert Lopez. It's time for another video. Yeah. Let's go. Today we're gonna be talking about how to show someone you love them, not just tell them. So let's do this. Let's go. All right, let's get started. Welcome back to another video. Thank you so much for cruising on in. So today we're gonna be talking about how to show someone you love them and not just tell them. Words are easy to say, especially if you've said them more than once. They kind of just roll off the tongue, such as, I love you, good job, great job, way to go, I'm so proud of you, you're the best. And those are great words and things to tell your loved ones, but we also need to show our loved ones we love them and not just tell them. So the example I'm going to use today is going to be a little interesting, and I was curious to see if it was going to work or not. So let's give it a go. Here we go. I was hanging out with my precious dog, Valentina, aka Tuna, aka Sweet Cheeks. She's my first female Rottweiler that I had, so she has a very special place in my heart. We've grown very close to each other, and I'm learning more about her every day. And it's easy for me to tell her how much I love her. Like, literally, like, say, Tuna, I love you. Sweet Cheeks, I love you. Sweet Cheeks, you're doing great. Sweet Cheeks, phenomenal job. Sweet Cheeks, I'm so proud of you. And although all these things that I say dissipate energy, and she definitely feels it and enjoys it, I believe, she also needs to see it. Goes back to that classic phrase, actions speak louder than words. So I was thinking, if she doesn't understand English, I know she understands my energy, and that's important, to dissipate love, to dissipate being proud of her, to dissipate the energy that she's the best. But I also gotta figure out how to show her. So in the past, that's what took me into studying how I can show her that I loved her. And that's when I found out that I show her that I love her by taking her out for walks, by taking her out for runs, by playing stimulating games with her to stimulate her mind and increase her confidence and self-esteem, by giving her plenty of exercise, by feeding her in a structured manner, by giving her rest, by giving her affection, the affection in a form of grooming her, petting her, spending time sitting with her, relaxing with her. These are all things that in their world represent showing me love. Now, of course, I'm not talking about maybe Valentina anymore. I'm talking about one of your human loved ones. So how do I do that? You listen, you pay attention, you talk to them, you learn about them, and gain and show interest in them and the things that they do. As you get to know them and the relationship grows, make sure that you're listening, that you're paying attention, that you're figuring out the little details of what it is that they like and maybe the things that they don't like so you can avoid those. Ask questions about the things they like. Ask questions about what they do for fun, what they do for on their spare time. One of my favorite questions to ask anyone is, what do you do for fun? Learn about where they like to go, where they'd like to go, where they have gone and they enjoyed it, and consider revisiting those locations with them, or learn about those locations and have a conversation with them about those locations. Asking a lot of questions gives you a lot of answers. Now, in this case, with my dog, and also maybe with cases where the other person isn't so talkative, what you do is you find out at least one, two, or three things that they're into, and you go hit up the world famous internet. You get on the internet and you start finding out if they're into sports, if they're into exercising, if they're into a specific type of exercising. Go watch a few videos on that exercising, get familiar with it, find out what it's about, find out the history, find out the whole culture behind it. In my case, my dog doesn't speak English or Spanish, so I went on the internet and found out, how can I show my dog that I love her? How can I stimulate my dog? How can I be a better owner of my dog? And specifically my type of dog, a Rottweiler, a female Rottweiler. But you could bring it down to a human level too, and you understand and you go study, what's he into? What's she into? She likes recording videos. He likes recording videos. What does he talk about? What kind of camera does he use? What kind of microphone do they use? How does he edit them? See, that's a conversation you can have. You get into what the person's into, and this way you can have nice, deep conversations about the thing that they're into. This shows that you care. This shows that you're proud of them. This shows that you love them, because you now have a more deep understanding of exactly what it is that they do, what it entails, And even saying, "I'm so proud of you," can come with like a detailed version of why you're so proud of him or her. "I'm proud of you because of all the work it takes to do what it is that you do. I know you have to do this, 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 and that. And I've seen you do some of it, although I haven't seen you do the other stuff, but I know you're in there doing it." So all that will show, wow, you really care. That "I'm proud of you" comes with roots, meaning you know what you're really proud of me for. And that goes the same with the "I love yous," with the "great jobs," with the "way to goes." If that person knows that you know what they're into and you know the details of what it is that they do, that shows that you care. That shows that those phrases that you say really are meant. So how do you show someone you love them? You learn about them, you gain interest about them, and you show you have interests in the things that they do. All right, my friends, that's going to do it for today's video. Thank you so much for stopping by. My name is Albert Lopez. I'm out. I'll see you guys in the next one.
Peace.
Yeah, that's going to do it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Once again, my name is Albert Lopez. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And also, if you haven't subscribed yet, I invite you to hit the subscribe button. My name is Albert Lopez, and I'll get you on the next one.
Peace.